السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Sorry, the connection is not very good at this time. طيب، we continue إن شاء الله تعالى with سورة الرحمن. And we'll go through إن شاء الله تعالى verses number 62 to 69 only إن شاء الله. 62 to 69 from سورة الرحمن. So open your Mus'haf inshallah and we'll start with recitation. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ومن دونهما جنتان. ومن that's إخفاء. ومن دونهما جن two counts جنتان فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. لمد مدهامتان. And this mad is six counts, like wala dalin. The one of the letters of mad, and then after it, the letter of shadda. So it takes two, six counts, the longest one. And then after it, meem takes two counts. Mudaha is six, and then the meem takes two counts. Mudahammatan, like this. فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. فيهما عينان نضاختان. فيهما عينان نضاختان. نضا. The ضاد is heavy and with the شدة. And the خاء is heavy. نضاختان. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. فيهما فاكهة ونخل ورمان. فيهما فاكهة two counts ونخل again إدغام ورم and the meme with shadda takes two counts. فبأي آلاء ربكما تكذبان. So this is these verses to the end of the surah talks about the other level of Jannah. It's lower, less than the previous one, but it's Jannah. Whoever is in Jannah, there is no misery for them, and each one would think that they are in the highest level of joy. So here in this, as it's mentioned also in Surah Al-Waqi'ah, for the Ashab Al-Yameen and for the Sabiqeen, which is the highest and the foremost. وَمِن تُنِهِمَا جَنَّةً, that's 62, that says, and below them, both in excellence basically, are two other gardens. So جَنَّةً is in the dual tense, two gardens. Jannah is garden, and Jannah, if it's mentioned in the sense of Jannah in general, which is paradise, which is the believers will be in Jannah. And in specific, this is refers to the gardens. So they have Jannatan, they have two gardens, you know, this is, you know, for the different levels of the believers. So, وَمِن دُونِهِمَا جَنَّتَان. وَمِن دُونِهِمَا جَنَّتَان. After mentioning those وَفِيلَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, they have the highest level. So min dunuhuma, that means less than them, other than them. Jannatan, two gardens. This is like the gardens of, or the Jannah for the Ashab al-Yameen. The first ones were for, was for the Sabiqun, as mentioned in Surah Al-Waqi'ah. Mudahammatan means that it's very dark green. And this is, we'll talk about that word, because of, you know, when something is dark green, that means it's been abundantly given water, and it's a good sign of the garden. So it's مُدَهَامَّتَان. فَبِأَيَّ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. So which of the favors of your Lord would you deny? فِيهِمَا عَيْنَانِ نَضَّاخَتَانِ, that in both of these gardens are two springs, عَيْنَانِ نَضَّاخَتَانِ. نَضَّاخَتَانِ, that means spouting, gushing water come from it very strongly. نَضَّاخَتَانِ, and even the word, when you hear it, نَضَّاخَتَانِ, it gives the sense of coming out with force. فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَ تُكَذِّبَانِ, so which of the favors of your Lord would you deny? فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانٌ, in it, or both of them, are fruit and palm trees and pomegranates. So in these jannat. And then it continues with more of what's mentioned in the rewards that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for them. So the, you know, talk about the words of it linguistically. So as the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, he said, جَنَّتَا مِنْ ذَهَبٍ, two gardens of gold, آنِيَتُهُمَا وَمَا فِيهِمَا, it's utensils and what's in it, and two جَنَّتْ وَجَنَّتَانِ مِنْ فِضَّةٍ, from silver, it's utensils and what's in it. So the first two is Allah, السَّابِقُونَ, the foremost, and the latter two is for the people of أَصْحَابُ الْيَمِينَ. Right, and it's very clear even when you compare between these verses and the verses mentioned previously about the highest or the higher level, you would find the differences of excellency. And this is one of the miraculous things even of the Quran. First of all, it says wa min dunihima jannatan. Dunihima means that it's less than them. That means the first one is mentioned first. This is the highest one, and the second one is min dunihima, and also. You see that the first one, ذَوَاتَ أَفْنَانٍ, it has branches, you know, and it's this one is مُدْهَامَّتَانٍ. That means it's the dark, it's explaining the dark green color of it instead of the long branches or so. Both are delights, of course, but it's one gives the sense of more of a higher level. And also here, you would say, you'd see the previous one, when it came to the water and the gushing water and so on, the first one was في معنى تجريان, the springs are water that is running. Here نضاختان, that means it's gushing out water with force, and they say that الجري is stronger than the first one, and that means it's more full than the one that is gushing water from. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And this is what Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said. And also here, it's mentioned specific fruits also. فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانٌ, has it in it fruits and نخل, palm trees, and رُمَّانٌ, هَاتٍ زَوْجٍ. They are from every types of fakiha, two types of it. So more of the delight and the pleasure than the second one. And that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for Jannah, as look at ourselves and our the Jannah. People enter Jannah by the mercy of Allah. So we seek the mercy of Allah. We don't look at our actions. Our actions is not sufficient. But rather we look at the mercy of Allah. We seek the mercy of Allah and not our actions. We try our best to perfect our actions and constantly repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But to enter Jannah and to be in the highest levels of Jannah, this is all by the mercy of Allah. So that therefore a person, when he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees in his heart the sincerity, this devotion, the best of his actions and abilities and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful. But as it's mentioned, وَهَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانِ إِلَّا الْإِحْسَانِ, is the recompense and the reward of al-ihsan is nothing but al-ihsan. So this is the mercy of Allah and the pleasure of Allah that he gives it to whoever he wills subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we look at the words وَمِن دُونِهِمَا, everything is so وَمِن دُونِهِمَا comes from دُون, دَل, وَاو, نُون, which means other than what's mentioned before, and also gives the meaning of closer or the lesser level. So وَمِن دُونِهِمَا جَنَّةً, two gardens from جِيم, نُون, نُون. فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ, then it says مُدَهَمَّةً, as we said, means dark green, comes from, the root of it is Dal Ha Mim. Dal Ha Mim. And Dam is the, Duhma is the darkness of the night. Right? So when they talk about the green when it's dark, right? So this is the word that they use. So mudahammatan, that means they're both dark green. فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ then فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانٌ فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ تَطْبُعُ الْفَاكِهَةَ أو I'm sorry, فِيهِمَا عَيْنَانِ نَضَّاخَتَانِ عَيْنَان from عَيْنْ يَأْنُون spring. And the عَيْن is the eye. And that's why the spring is called the عَيْن, because it looks like the eye. So with all of the different words in the Quran that talks about أَعْيُون and عَيْن and عَيْنَان and so on. نَضَّاخَتَان gushing forth from نُون ضَاد خَاء. And that's what النضخ means. And this is the only word in the Quran that's called نَضَّاخَتَان. And نَضْح with a ha is of a lesser power. So نَضَّاخَتَان. فَبِأَيَّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ فِيهِمَا فَاكِهَةٌ وَنَخْلٌ وَرُمَّانِ. In it, in both of them, فَاكِهَة, fruits, from فَاكَف, ha, and we talked about that. وَنَخْل, نَخْل, date palm, from the same three letters. And رُمَّان, which is pomegranates. And this is what is known of that. So that's, you know, what's with these verses. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people of Jannah. And it shows that no matter what a person gets in this world, you know, compared to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the believers, as a sign of a complete and a sound and a good intellectual person, person would choose the what's everlasting over what goes away. And a person would leave something that he loves for something that he loves more. And people do this in this life. Meaning, if you ask your child, for example, you know, about the best place that you want to be, he loves a place so much to be in. Whether it's a nice house or a big house or a nice palace or whatever there is. But if he has the choice between having a place like that but without his mother that he loves dearly versus a place that of a lesser luxury and so on, but with his mother, which one would he choose? He would choose the one that would be with his mother. He would say that. So the lesson learned here is that he leaves something that he loves for something that he loves more. And this is how life is. We cannot have all of our choices together at one place or at one thing. So the same thing, we live our life. You leave what you love, like sleeping at Fajr time, for example. It's something that a person loves to do, especially if he slept late. Right? But he leaves that for what he loves more, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the worship of Allah. And the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for the believers. And this is always the struggle for the human beings in this life when it comes to sins and the obligations. You always have to make the choice of leaving what you like for what you like more. What you love for what you love more. And the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hearts of the believers should be, you know, overtakes everything else in this life. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحِبُّكُمُ اللَّهَ. The love of Allah, isn't it sufficient for the person to sacrifice many things in this life? The believers, they would even sometimes sacrifice their own life and their wealth and everything, even their own families, if they oppose them or they are against the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the love of one's family, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. So this is how a person reaches the highest levels of things, and to be patient and to have the sincerity, and of course with that to follow the way of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one, by his mercy, he grants whoever he wills the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we'll stop here, inshallah, we'll continue next time. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, barakah, Muhammad, wa sallam, wa sallam, wa sallam, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.